Welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, we spent the last couple of days fixing up this data set, and we're close, but we still have time, in this case quarters, going across our columns, and it is a disaster to create a pivot table from this. Let me show you what happens. We choose OK. Maybe I choose to have a report by region, but then I include my numeric fields, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. Because they're separate fields, they're not anything that I can total. I'd have to go into calculated fields and calculated total for that. Just a real, not a good way to create a pivot table. Well, there's an amazing trick, and I want to send a shout out to Mike Alexander. Mike is my co-author on pivot table data crunching, both the regular and 2007 edition, and Mike showed me this amazing trick. Let's just go through it. I'm going to insert a new column here, and it's called key. And basically, I'm going to take all of my fields in A, B, and C and concatenate them together with an ampersand. And between each field, I'm going to put a semicolon so I can break them back out again later. All right, so you see that we've taken all the data from A, B, and C and put it in one single column. I'll double click the fill handle to copy that down. Well, now I'm going to create a pivot table from columns E through I, but I'm not going to use the new pivot table interface. I need the old pivot table interface. And the best way to do that is Alt D and then P. Here's the old pivot table interface. I'm going to choose multiple consolidation ranges. Click Next. I'll create the page fields. Click Next. Specify my data range. Click Add. And then simply click Finish. Now, what I get is a pivot table that is exactly identical to the original data set. And you're saying, boy, what's this? Why do we even care? Well, if we go all the way down to the grand total of the grand total, there is an amazing trick. If you double click any cell in a pivot table, it will give you all the records that are behind that data. And because we use multiple consolidation ranges, when I double click down here, I get a brand new spreadsheet. And look what happened. Excel took my data, which was going across the sheet, and made it go down the sheet. So where I used to have columns for Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4, I now have four times as many rows, one for Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. And what I have to do, I'm going to insert a couple of columns and use data and text to columns in order to split column A back out into three fields. So we have data that is delimited on the second tab. I'm going to say it's by a semicolon and just click Finish. We now have model, region, district, the quarter, and revenue broken out into separate fields, ready to go, ready to create a pivot table. Well, next week, we're going to start to take a look at pivot tables in Excel 2007, and so this will be a perfect data set with which to start. Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.